I'm going to show you absolutely everything that you need to know to succeed as a Frost Mage in Cataclysm Classic. This is going to be the ultimate guide for you, okay? We're going to start off with what races we want to pick. If you're going to be picking Alliance, I would say to go for Worgen. It's the shiny new race as well, so woohoo, extra brownie points there. Dark Flight is a 2-minute racial cooldown, giving us a 40% movement speed increase for 10 seconds. This is going to be fantastic mobility in certain raid fights, etc., where we're running around like headless chickens. Secondary, Viciousness. Increasing our critical strike by 1% is a no-brainer. The only other one I would recommend as Alliance would be Human, but really that is more due to the reputation gain you can get from the diplomacy racial, because some of the enchants I'm going to be showing you in this video do actually require reputation, and that'll just make life a little bit easier. But it doesn't really have the same combat effectiveness that we have with Worgen. If you are going Horde, I would say if we go for Troll for the Berserking racial. It's a 3-minute cooldown, increasing your haste by 20% for 10 seconds, and this is like a mini Bloodlust or Heroism buff that you can get. There are a few bosses in the Firelands that will also make use of our Beast Slaying 5% damage modifier. There's not many of them though in the whole of Cataclysm, so it's not huge. The main reason for taking it as Horde is for the Berserking buff. For the stat priority, first and foremost, we are of course going to want Intellect and as much as possible. After that, we want to make sure we're hitting our hit cap, which is going to be 17% for casters in Cataclysm Classic. For crit chance, which is our next priority, we want to get this to 33.33% and then stop there. There is a reason for this, and that is because of one of our talents, Fingers of Frost, is going to triple our crit chance when we have it affected. Meaning quite often we will actually be guaranteed a crit when we get it to 33.33%. After that we can go for haste, and then after that it's going to be mastery. After mastery, just any more crit is going to be fine. It just won't be as useful at that point. Regarding our mastery, this is called Frostburn. All of your spells deal 26% increased damage against frozen targets, and each point of mastery is going to increase that. Now, we are going to be doing a lot of damage to frozen targets in this rotation, mainly because of our talents. Let's look at those now. Of course, most of them going into the Frost Tree, us being Frost, of course. Starting off with Shatter. Multiplies your critical strike chance of all your spells against frozen targets by 3. Hence why we want 33.33% crit, taking our crit chance up to 99.99 when tripled. And that is going to be on frozen targets. And increases the damage done by Frostbolt against frozen targets by 20%. Piercing Ice, increasing our crit chance by 3%. And Early Frost, reducing the cast time of Frostbolt, which the effect will become inactive for 15 seconds after use. So basically, if every now and again when we use our Frostbolt, it will be reduced. We've got 3 out of 3 into Ice Flows, reducing the cooldown on some of our ice spells, and 1 point into Permafrost. Your chill effects reduce the target's speed and the target's healing received as well. In addition, whenever you deal spell damage, your water elemental is healed for 5% of the amount dealt. FYI, we do have a water elemental, as you can see here, that we are going to be using in battle. And you can summon this and just keep it up at all times. On to the next one, we have Icy Veins, a cooldown I'm going to be discussing in the rotation part of the video. And then Fingers of Frost. Now, when I spoke about our crit chance and also the Shatter talent, Fingers of Frost is actually what's going to really help achieve this. Gives your offensive chill effects a 20% chance to give you Fingers of Frost, which causes your next Ice Lance or Deep Freeze to act as if your target were frozen. Now remember, when the target is frozen, that is when we're going to get the triple crit chance from our Shatter. So TLDR, Fingers of Frost gives some of our chill spells a chance to give us the Finger of Frost's effect. When we get that effect, it will be as if the target is frozen. When we do critical strikes against frozen targets, we're then going to be doing triple the chance of crits, and therefore basically guaranteed if we are at 33.33% crit. Hopefully that makes sense. It's also going to increase Ice Lance damage by 25%, and it can accumulate up to 2 charges. We then have the improved Freeze talent, giving your Water Elemental's Freeze spell a 100%, so guaranteed chance, to grant us 2 charges of Fingers of Frost. More on that shortly. Enduring Winter on the next row, reducing the mana cost of all your spells by 10%. In addition, your Frostbolt spell has a 100% chance to grant up to 10 party or raid members mana regen. And then we've got Brain Freeze, another really interesting one. Your spells no longer trigger arcane missiles, instead your frost damage spells with chilling effects have a 15% chance to cause your next Fireball or Frostfire Bolt to be instant cast and cost no mana. When Frostfire Bolt is instant, it can benefit from Fingers of Frost. Brain Freeze cannot be triggered by Frostfire Bolt. A bit confusing, but I'm going to explain that more in the rotation. Cold Snap is going to reduce all of your cooldowns or reset your cooldowns. And then we've got Ice Barrier. This is a defensive, instantly shielding you, absorbing damage. It lasts a minute. When the shield holds, spellcasting will not be delayed by damage. 2/2 into Reactive Barrier, giving the caster a 100% chance for Ice Barrier to automatically cast with no mana upon taking damage that lowers your caster's life below 50% health. So when you go below 50% health, boom, you've been Ice Barriered, baby. This effect obeys Ice Barrier's cooldown and will trigger the cooldown when activated, however. 2/2 into Frostfire Orb. Your Frostfire Orb gains a chill effect, slowing targets damaged by it by 40% for 2 seconds. In addition, reduces the speed of targets slowed by your Frostfire Bolt's chill effect. And lastly, Deep Freeze. It's on a 30-second cooldown, stunning the target, only usable on frozen targets, deals damage to targets that are permanently immune to stuns. Then we've got a few talents which we're putting into Fire and Arcane. 3/3 into Burning Soul, and 2/2 into Master of the Elements. Master of the Elements, your spell criticals will refund 30% of their base mana. We're then only using Burning Soul to get down to the next row for Ignite. Reduces the casting time lost when you're attacked. It's helpful if that happens. It's unlikely in a raid that we'll be being attacked that much, but it does help us get down to the next row for Ignite. Your critical strikes and non-periodic fire damage spells cause the target to burn for an additional 40%. Now remember that this is saying your critical strikes from non-periodic fire spells will put a dot or damage over time on your enemy for a percentage of the damage done, only on critical strikes. We also need to remember that most of the time, we're going to be using our Frost Fire Bolt. Yes, it counts as Frost and Fire. We're going to be using this with Fingers of Frost, at which point the target will be frozen, and we'll be doing triple the crit on them, or have triple the chance to crit. Because of that, then, when we're using our Frost Fire Bolt, it's usually going to be guaranteed to be a critical strike, meaning that we're often going to guarantee, or just about guarantee, that our critical strikes from Frost Fire Bolt will be putting an extra dot on the target. And you start to see how it all synergizes together nicely now. Lastly, 2 points into Neverwind Presence, increasing your spell haste by 2%. For the glyphs we're going to be using, we've got Deep Freeze, meaning it does additional damage, Frostfire, increasing the damage done by Frostfire, and your Frostfire Bolt now deals 3% additional damage over 12 seconds, stacking up to 3 times, but no longer reduces the victim's movement speed, which we don't care about in raids, and often dungeons as well. And lastly, Griff of Frostbolt increases the critical strike chance of Frostbolt by 5%, again, increasing your crit chance there. For mages, it's really just defensives. Glyph of Ice Barrier increases the amount of damage absorbed by Ice Barrier. Blink, increasing the distance you blink with. If you don't know what Blink is, it teleports you ahead like this. Can be great for getting out of God knows what you're standing in fights, etc., where you need a lot of mobility. Lastly, Glyph of Invisibility increases movement speed while invisible. Invisibility is a spell here. Invisibility fades the caster invisibility over 3 seconds, reducing threat each second. You can see you're moving 40% faster. The effect is cancelled if you perform any actions. Again, another great mobility. Did I say mobility? Mobility ability. It's a great mobility ability that is also going to reduce our threat and increase movement speed with that glyph. For the minor, they're more quality of life, in reducing mana cost of Arcane Brilliance. That, of course, is our spell we use to increase intellect of our fellow party and raid members. Glyph of Slowfall, where it no longer needs a reagent, and Glyph of Conjuring, reducing the mana cost of our conjuring spells as well by 50%. So how does it all come together into a single target, an AoE rotation? First things first, our top priority is using Deep Freeze. It is on a 30-second cooldown, stunning the target, only usable on frozen targets, remember, dealing damage to targets that are permanently immune to stuns. So you can only use it when it's frozen, and we basically need Fingers of Frost to be up for this to happen. After that, we're going to use our Frostfire Orb. Basically, this is going to throw a big orb at the target, launches a Frostfire Orb from your mage's position, dealing damage every second. You can see I've now got 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost, and therefore I can use my Deep Freeze, which is going to absorb or consume 1 stack of Fingers of Frost. I had 2 stacks, now I've got 1. Ice Lance and Deep Freeze act as if your target were frozen, and Ice Lance deals increased damage, remember. The actual next priority on our list is actually in the middle here. It's not Frostfire Bolt, but if we look down here to our water elemental, it's their freeze spell. It's annoying that you can't put this onto your action bar, even though it's from your pet. 25 second cooldown, blasts enemies in an 8-yard radius for frost damage and freezes them in place. Don't forget there's the improved freeze talent we took, giving your water elementals freeze a 100% chance to grant 2 charges of Finger of Frost. So basically, when we use freeze on this target here, for example, we are guaranteed to get 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost. The next priority is going to be using our Frostfire Bolt. And we want to use this if we have both Brain Freeze and Fingers of Frost up. Fingers of Frost meaning it's frozen, and Brain Freeze meaning it's instant and costs no mana. So we're going to use our Frostfire Bolt at this point in the rotation only if we have both Fingers of Frost and Brain Freeze up. Then we're going to use our Ice Lance only if we have 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost. And then we're going to use our Frostfire Bolt if we have Brain Freeze, but we don't have Fingers of Frost. So just to recap so far, we're going to use our Deep Freeze on cooldown whenever we can, and that's going to be with Fingers of Frost. We're going to use our Frostfire Orb on cooldown. We're going to use our Frostfire Bolt if we have Fingers of Frost and Brain Freeze, like we do now. And then we're going to use our Ice Lance if we have 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost. After that, we're going to use our Frostfire Bolt if we only have Brain Freeze, but we don't have any Fingers of Frost. And then after that, we're going to use our Ice Lance if we only have 1 stack of Fingers of Frost. So again, we're using it here. We've got 2 stacks. We're only going to use it here if we've got 1 stack. And after that, we're just going to use our Frost Bolt. So again, using Deep Freeze whenever we can, using Frostfire Orb on cooldown, using Frostfire Bolt if we've got Fingers of Frost and Brain Freeze, using Ice Lance with 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost, using Frostfire Bolt only with Brain Freeze and no Fingers of Frost. If we had both, we would have been using it here. Then going down to only 1 stack of Fingers of Frost, we're going to use Ice Lance. And as our filler, it's going to be Frost Bolt. In between here, so after we use our Frostfire Orb, the next priority is going to be generating 2 stacks of Fingers of Frost with our Water Elementals Freeze. We do also have 2 cooldowns, so Cold Snap and Icy Veins. Cold Snap, when activated, the spell finishes the cooldown on all frost spells you've recently cast. And if you need sudden or extreme burst damage, that is when you should use Cold Snap. As you can see, it's going to reduce your cooldowns to 0. Icy Veins should be used on cooldown, hastening your spellcasting, increasing spellcasting by 20%, and reducing pushback suffered. So we can use that as our main DPS cooldown. If you're wondering what to do in an AoE situation for multiple targets, well, we can use Flame Strike, because remember, we are actually doing damage with a few flame talents as well, and you want to alternate your Flame Strike and Blizzard. So we can do Flame Strike damage here, and then we can alternate it with our Blizzard. If we have enemies grouped up in front of us, we can use Cone of Cold. As you can see, targets in a cone in front of the caster dealing damage and slowing enemies in front of us. It's also good for slowing us. And if you want to go for like a really mana efficient route, you can also use your Arcane Explosion if you would like, but you do need to be near the target for that, whereas Flame Strike and Blizzard can be used from quite a distance. And again, using those intermittently between each other. A few other things to note, of course, is our Time Warp cooldown, which is our Bloodlust or Heroism, increasing the haste of our party and raid members. We've got a really tiny little cooldown, which is Mirror Image. It's a very small DPS cooldown. You get mirror images that are going to attack as you do. You've also got your Molten and Mage armor. Ideally, we're going to be using Molten armor most of the time. Causes fire damage when you're hit, increases your spell crit by 3%, and reduces the chance you're critically hit by 5%. The only time we're going to use Mage armor is if we really, really need mana and we're desperate for it. Increases your resistances and causes you to regenerate 3% of your mana every 5 seconds. In addition, the duration of all harmful magic effects on you are reduced. So really, again, we're only using that if we really need the mana. Keep your water elemental up at all times. And then you've got your Arcane Brilliance, increasing intellect for everyone. Counterspell is your Interrupt or Kick, interrupting your enemy's spellcasting. If you are running out of mana, you can also use a Conjure Mana Gem to conjure mana gems, which you can use to restore mana. You can conjure these before you go into the fight. And Invisibility and Blink we've already discussed. For the consumables and professions, etc., you'll see above my head here that there are 2 enchants, one for head and one for shoulders. This is with the Guardians of Hyrule Reputation and Ferrozane in Deepholm. I have got reputation guides on my channel. I'll link it in the description for you. You do need to get rep with these to get them, and they are the biz enchants for head and shoulders. Regarding gems, I would go for the Brilliant Inferno Ruby in red slots, giving intellect, the Reckless Ember Topaz in yellow, giving intellect and haste. Purified Demon's Eye for intellect and spirit in blue. For meta, it's going to be the Burning Shadow Spirit Diamond, increasing intellect and crit. Regarding professions, I would go with tailoring, one because we wear cloth anyway, so it's a win-win, but mainly because of the enchant we can put on our cloak, giving us a chance to increase our spell power by 295 for 15 seconds. Secondly, enchanting is a great one, again, because you can enchant whatever you like, but also because we can enchant our rings as an enchanter with 23 spell power per ring, adding up to 46 spell power. Your weapon enchant, which is the other main enchant we need, is going to be Power Torrent, giving you a chance to increase intellect by 500 for 12 seconds. For our consumables, Flask of the Draconic Mind is going to increase your intellect by 300 for an hour. Volcanic Potion, increasing intellect by 1200 for 25. And there's also these flame caps, depending if you're using fire spells, etc., which you will be. You can use these to a chance to strike a ranged or melee target for 40 fire damage. Also increases fire spell power by 80. So these are actually gathered by herbalism, and they don't, or aren't, should I say, exclusive with any of your potions, etc., meaning you can use these as well. They're farmed in Outland, and again, is farmed by herbalism, and they don't stack with anything. So this is actually a really sneaky little thing that us mages have up our sleeve. Severed Sagefish Head, giving intellect and stamina for the food, and a mythical healing potion if you do need a healing potion. And that's it. That is pretty much how you're going to play Frost Mage in Cataclysm Classic. Hopefully this video was really helpful for you. Please do let me know in the comments and like and subscribe if you did enjoy it. I've done all class guides for you in Cataclysm. And feel free to join the Discord if you do need any extra help. You can also consider joining my Patreon, where you're going to get behind the scenes spreadsheets that help with key bindings and things, LVY profiles, and full written guides that I've put on there for you guys as well. Considering how many people now use ad blockers, especially in the gaming space, and how little us creators make from gaming ads on YouTube, subscribing to Patreon is the best way to support the channel, especially as I only do this in my evenings outside my 9 to 5. It is really, really appreciated. It also opens up a VIP channel in Discord where you can get extra help if needed. There is a link to it in the description should you be considering joining. And if you do, thank you in advance. Again, if you are looking for any other class guides, whether it's Mage or other classes, I've spent weeks now getting them all filmed for you for launch, and they're in this playlist here. Also, check out my channel for tier lists, reputation guides and dungeon guides and all other stuff like that that's going to help you on your journey in Cataclysm Classic.